This time, let's look at the drop rate denominator method. You will see that it's a slightly condensed method in comparison to the extended version because it carries over your answer from part one into part two. Let's take a look. So the first bit is exactly the same. We are being asked to calculate mils per R. So we know that that's going to be in our answer. Therefore, we know we need to do mils divided by hours, and the information we have under volume is 250, and that's over 5 hours. So we have 250 mils to be given over 5 hours, and that will give us 50 mils per hour. Again, to set up the rate, we're looking for our answer that was in mils per hour, so that's 50. And our volume is the amount that we're giving in total, that's 250. We'll click run. Now, as you can see, the drop rate denominator version keeps this bit of information here for you. You need to carry this answer across mils per hour. Now, what we are doing is working out the drop rate denominator. The drop rate denominator is what goes in this box. To calculate the drop rate denominator, we need some more information. Now, the only two bits of information that we use in our extended version that we haven't yet used are the 60 minutes per hour and our drops per mil given under the IV administration set. To calculate your drop rate denominator, you need to do the 60 minutes per hour divided by, in this case, our 12 drops per minute. You'll need to do this on paper and then pop in your answer. So 60 divided by 12 gives us 5 for the drop rate denominator. And now we have our calculation is 50 mils per hour divided by the 5 drop rate denominator to give us 10. And remember, the question tells us what we're calculating, our drops per minute. When we click next, we again have the opportunity to set the drops per minute. When we click next, we'll get our feedback and we can see that we've been able to do our answer correctly. So those are the two methods. You will get to choose whilst you're practicing which one you want to use, and you'll get that choice in the exam as well. As with all of the Safe Medicate practice tests, you can do these at any time when you have a spare moment and you just want to practice to get better in preparation for your exam. You'll get all the information you need about your exam, the number of questions and the types of questions and how long you'll have, from your module. So make sure that you have a look at that information so that you're practicing the right types of questions and giving yourself the right amount of time. If you have any questions about Safe Medicate, you can always contact your module organiser, or you can get in touch with me at patricia.harris@uea.ac.uk, or come along to some of our drop-ins that you'll see advertised across the school.